Hey everyone, Deadpine here. Welcome back to Hardcore Tarkov. As promised, loading into this lighthouse raid with our shotgun. We'll see what happens. We'll try to make it work. We'll try to get some scav kills, honestly, and just go from there. So great stuff, and I'll see y'all in raid. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Don't forget to hit like and subscribe. We're keeping this. This is how I do intros. Alrighty, here we go. Is this the villa spawn or is this the mountain spawn? I think this is the mountain spawn, right? Yeah. Which would be kind of good with any other gun here. They may have saw me just then. Probably helped a lot that they were hurting a lot, because I hit him at some point over here. Oh yeah, I hit him in the chest. This does hold more than this, I guess. It lets us hold the packa. Oh, I can wear the packa. Right, I don't have any armor on. Classic Deadpine. Okay, pretty sure you can go this way. Can somebody get the map real quick for Lighthouse? Just try not to go kaboom here. Wasn't really looking through the scope there. I was actually looking for just movement. Thank you, Carlos. Okay, so they're further to the right, the mines. Scav. Okay, I kind of like these slugs. They're doing something. Now that the shotgun doesn't kick 8 feet into the air, it's kind of nice. They're the super performance slugs. They're fairly accurate. And have a really good velocity. So the rogue shouldn't be pissed at me, which is nice. We know there's a Mosin man over here somewhere. Oh, there they go. There goes a team of two. Okay, we might be able to get up in front of them. Not sure if they're looking to farm rogues. I think I just heard him to the right. That's one of the tanks you have to mark. I should have brought in a bunch of markers. I wonder if they're going for, like, killing rogue strat. I think they are. Oh. That might be a rogue. So I hear a bunch of suppress shooting in there, so I'm assuming they're trying to get them. Man, I really I should have brought markers and stuff with me. I didn't think about this. In case they open up the quest keys that we need, you know? So you can get down right here. Oh, there's that Mosin man, though. Oh, that's a scav? Freddy, thank you so much. That's not a scav. So they talk as a scav. I'm so confused. But they weren't a scav? Maybe the scav talked behind him. So that's why I took the time to take out the shotgun, you know? Damn, GG. Well, we got a player kill. Got a player kill. We got a couple scav kills. Voice clips, maybe? Maybe? Yeah. It's entirely possible. Oh, they were player scav. Oh, everything makes way more sense. Okay, that's fine. So again, two more towards that and one towards that, towards our balaclava. Nice shots on their part, by the way. Good movement. Really great movement. I wish I'd been using my Mosin, but it's all good. I do like that, like, for taking out scavs quietly, or not quietly, but, like, from a range, those slugs do work quite well. I gotta give them props. I gotta give them props for that. Nice. All right, sorry, I was struggling and deciding on what I wanted to do there, but I think we're gonna hop back in. Maybe with that. And do we have any slugs? I guess Magnum Buckshot's better for that. We have these Grizzly Slugs, which I don't think are very accurate. We have 7 Light Slugs left. Oh, no, they are accurate. Comparatively. All right, we'll just try using those then. Try this whole slug thing out, you know? Just for getting the scav kills, basically. And if we get into a longer range fight, we can work with it that way. And then we'll slap one of these on, and then we'll go trade for another scav vest. Okay, good, we have extras. Do I put armor on here, though? I think we do, if we can. Basically, if this is available, we do. No. 19 minutes till that resets. Okay, so then we go going basic here. And not worry about it. I do think I want the contacts. Could go in nighttime, but I don't think I want to risk the MVGs with a slugged shotgun, you know? I want all upside here, I think. Is how I would like that. So we'll do this. That's on 7. We'll put this on 6. Well, I guess I have one of those, but... Yeah, you know what? Put one of those in there. We'll put you on 6. Okay. Yeah, let's go at least get these last 2 scav kills, and then with the potential of getting some more player kills with a sniper shotgun, air quotes. And then just try to get some stuff done there. And we are going to go nighttime. I just hopefully there will be less player scavs. But honestly, maybe there's less of them in the daytime. I genuinely don't know. Oh, let's bring a bunch of markers in, because we have a ton of tasks here. Hold on. Yeah, so it's a marker in the helicopter in the center, if they get done. Yep, that's the briefcase we could do there. Or maybe that one. No, that's on the streets. It's lost contact? Oh, that's in that, yeah, I know where that is. Okay, we could try to do that. Let's turn these in. I do know where that is. No. Technically that, but not worrying about it. And then this one, there's a bunch of these to mark. They're all inside, though. And then it's this one that, these are the tough ones. I think this needs a jammer, right, chat? I'm pretty sure this needs a jammer. So we'll bring a jammer. We'll bring some of those. And then the data that we could potentially get as well. But I think I'll bring in a jammer. And... Can I get 2 of those? No, I cannot. Let's get... Gear stuff bought up here. Let's just get another 1,000 of that. I like this. This is a good way to do this. Let's just bring like 4 jammers. That's a really good way to get money spent on skier and ragman, which I like. Compass can go away for sure. We'll put the jammer there. It's worth more. Okay, we'll try to get those down. All right, good. Yeah. See y'all in there. All right, pretty quick load-in on this one. Like that. Feel like I'm turned around here. I think this is the spawn the Mosin guy had. Maybe? No, this is the same spawn we had before. I just derped it up. Which I'll take. Tough to see. Some weird artifacting around the site here. Is that the tree I just saw, or I see something going running left to right there? I care more about scab kills right now than I do player kills. Thank you, Freddy, for the 222. That played a little quieter. I was just in the middle of running. It's meant to be like a far-off scav. I do appreciate the tip, though. Funny enough, the movement caught my eye more than the sound. Well, it's 51 subs, but 45 of them were from one person. Which is still not quiet, of course. It's still epic. Do not get me wrong. Do not get me wrong. But it is... you know, it was... It comes in bursts instead of... Is what I mean. Everything is in bursts today. Instead of, you know, trickles, slow trickles in. So I wonder if the AGS killed that player they were shooting at. Possible. Even likely. But I do think patience is... not necessarily a bad thing to have here. Give scavs behind us time to spawn in. lights just switched to on, which is pretty cool. Not looking through the scope here. I'm looking at the top left of the screen, top right. Very quiet raid. I wonder if we should go to the train area. And try to get our last two scav kills there. And then loot there, because there's some good stuff there. We have Northern Checkpoint, right? No, we don't. Okay. I actually don't know where Mountain Pass is. Or is that the one that requires Red Rebel? Because Southern Road's always there. Path of Shoreline's always there. It also kind of feels like there's probably a, a body over here of a bear or a rogue that, or a, of a Usek that annoyed the rogues. That's just kind of free for the taking. God damn it. Thank you, Carlos. This is fairly exposed up here, but... Oh, there we go. That might be a player. Could just as easily be a scav. Or a player scav. See if we hear any shots. Player scav, maybe? Oh no, that's a scav. Or player scav. Player scav or player, not sure which. They're jumping, so I didn't hit him in the leg. I thought I hit him in the leg. All right. I don't feel safe here anymore. And that's okay. Bet you the super slugs were a little bit more accurate. All right, that's unfortunate, but I think we do go around, wrap around here. And I'm gonna go to the train yard area. Look for scav kills. That's like in that area? That's weird. Requite gaming. That's quite good. Thank you so much for the Prime for 7 months. Appreciate you. Thank you. Let's get some love live chat, please, for number 52 today. Unreal. Factually, unreal. Twisted my leg there the wrong way. That was a mistake. Oh, I need food, huh? Oh, nice. That will help. So somebody might be farming rogues here. Not up again, damn. Oh no, it is. Maybe that's it. I don't know. I actually don't know. Hey, no worries, Freddy. We'll catch you tomorrow for the drops event. Thanks for hanging out, as always. Appreciate you. This might be one where we could hop in here and grab all the data. It's just not stopping. One tap. All right, that would explain why I didn't hit that guy so much. Even at 80% accuracy, maybe not so accurate. Yeah, I bet you the other slugs are like 120% or 150%, I think. So. Hello. Let's check. 170. Instead of 120 or whatever it was. Bro 5 with that prime. Let's go. Thank you so much. As a brand spanking Edmood member, you love to see it. Oh, hello. Fine. Whoa. Go. Let's get some epic love night chat, please. There's another 53 today. You absolutely love to see that. Cheers, man. Thank you, thank you. Sure all those grizzlies went, but I think I'm not gonna really worry about it too much. Let's look for a drill. This might be a rinse and repeat kind of deal as well, you know, and that would be okay too. Maybe if we go over here, more scabs will spawn in over there. Sometimes too. Also check the grow room in here. Gold item in there. Stims on the shelves. This is a therapist task later on. I think I have to do the chalet driver first or whatever. There's a tanker we can mark back here as well. I want to say it's that. Might as well get it done. Is it two back here? As well. It is. Wait for that one to finish. That way this side of the map's done. What we could do from this, that's a pretty far away, but I was gonna say we could go, we don't have northern checkpoint here, so we actually have to go back this other way, which is perfect. So it means we need to start leaving. Yeah. So we'll go pick up therapist's task. We heard a rogue in the tower, so nobody farmed him completely. So I'm not going to bother with the stuff inside. We are going to look for drills. Just quick visual checks. We'll hit all these as well. I don't know what that one is. Ah. Money's money, I guess. That's not really where I want to be hearing that. That could be a player scav trying to farm the rogues. Metal cutting scissors. Bunch of spawns over here as well. Oh, we can also wait for the train. Not a bad idea, but let's see what we get. It's a long run up the coast. Yeah, I might just wait for the train regardless, actually. Here it comes. Kind of need food, huh? We should be all right. Maybe. No, wrong type of drill. Drink that though. I don't need this. You don't have electric, it's the right type. Not sure what you mean. Med bags. Medical supply crates. And basically anywhere like loose med spawns can happen. I think there's also a barter for them. That might be a level 2 therapist thing. I missed some spawns over here. I'm sure I did. It's a shame I can't get another scav. Like that, the idea of this thing as well. Let's just get an ACOG scope, and I absolutely love ACOG scopes. Guess I didn't loot in this corner. Oh, there's some food supplies over here too. CSP? What's that? Oh, hello. I mean, I kind of like this strat. This is just money for us. Let's just do that. What's CSP? Oh, copper slugs. I see. That's fine. Here's a little bit of food. Or gives us a little bit of energy back. Okay. Let's go check this corner real quick. There's some spawns. Oh, there's a fuel con. We probably should make room for that. Especially if we're going for Red Rebel. Yeah, you know, we'll get rid of that for the kick tape. So, what? What is that? Oh, duffel bags too, yeah. Oh. Yeah, we'll take those, right? Yeah, those are the flashbang rounds. Yeah, we'll definitely take those. I think I've looted everything then. Or just about. Guess we'll pick over this again. I mean, I guess nice if you like Iron Maiden, which I'm assuming you do. You know, tribute bands are cool. Hose there. Yeah. Metal scissors there. So there's spawns in here, but they're not what we need. And that's okay. There's our minute warning. Now, this used to have loot on it, but I haven't seen loot on here in a while. What if there's like a bug with it? I mean, it could be the dynamic looting thing, but yeah, I don't know. Weird. All right, GG. Got a scav kill. Got some cool stuff. Got a backup shotgun. Honestly, a lot of these super performance slugs are pretty sick, to be honest. So I'll take it. Nice. 1,200 exactly. All right. We're probably going to rinse and repeat. We might as well get this last one going. All right. I think we're just saving everything for now until we need to make that last push. These will be good for our flashbang task. I also do quite like the idea of having that. I also kind of like the idea of doing that. These barter. BS rounds are fantastic. Love that. These all barter. We're not doing that weekly. Does that fit? It fits. Nice. We'll do that. And then we'll just use these super performance. The reason I want to do that is I wanted to save some of these here. Because I actually am really enjoying using these. These are working well for me. It's the accuracy buff plus the better recoil, you know. It's pretty good. And this does add accuracy, right? Yes, 5% accuracy. Okay. I believe, as they say, rinse and repeat. I think that's where we're at. Yeah, we still have one more nighttime. Nice. See you, Brad. All right, here we go. 14-inch barbecue chicken pizza in my stomach. Realized it's 6 p.m. and I didn't eat today. Dang, yeah. That's something. We get the same spawn again? I think we did. The spawn confuses me sometimes, though. Or is this the chalet spawn? Or valet, whatever the heck this thing is called. It's snowing again? No, this is it. Just went the wrong way. There's always a good chance whoever spawns there is either turtled up waiting for me to run by. Or just move forward. You know. She's totally fine. I think we'll get back to this last spot we were. We have a little bit more accurate slugs now, which will be good. I don't know if we can go this way. Also, I don't know how much cover the shadowy dark places have here. I really love just one scav. Happy New Year's, Scooby-Doo. Hope you've been well. Hope your holidays have been treating you all right. Oh, lights have turned out, which is actually good for us. Okay, that's interesting. That's up. That is up at the whatever those things are, the villas. Maybe we'll get somebody coming through here. That is a lot of grenades. Oh, that was a person. Love to see a scav walk across here. Get that done real quick. Okay. Grenades are still happening, huh? Do we have northern checkpoint this time? I don't think you do on that one. Yeah. Oh, I forgot to bring more markers. I should have brought some more markers. Yeah, I filled up my bag again with some markers. But again, the rogues aren't going to get hurt. I'm not doing the rogues with this shotgun, that's for sure. Too much margin. Error margin there. It's not at me. But we could have a potential ambush here. You know, we're tactically waving. Remember that, chat. If we do get this kill, and that person watches the VOD, we're tactically waiting here. They, of course, killing all the scavs. Which is fine. Of course, there's a good chance they just see us and absolutely own us. Okay. But yeah, hopefully everyone's New Year's are going really well. Doing some fun, I say fun lighthouse, but you know, we're doing some lighthouse stuff here. Remember, if you're new, to drop a follow. We're going to drops tomorrow at 6 p.m. The stream for tomorrow's drops will start in like 26 hours, 23 and a half or 25 and a half hours, somewhere in there from now. We'll be going as long as we can. Goal is the 12 hours, but if we don't get that, you guys, I'll definitely host you up to somebody who's doing, who has a nighttime shift and is easily doing the nighttime shift, you know? I would imagine this person who's over here is probably looting the houses up top there. Oh, gotta not slouch in this chair. I think this chair might be too low for me. It's always intense, the calm before the storm here. I keep thinking that tire's a body too. There's also a chance whoever's here finds something good and they just leave on path of lighthouse. That is absolutely allowed. Callie with the raid! Welcome, everybody. That's a little further north than we wanted. What's up, Mac Insane? Welcome, Raiders. How was your cast today? What were you up to? Or if you're just tuning in, my name is Deadpine. We're playing a little Hardcore Tarkov right now. Thank you. Yeah, if you've not gone and followed my good friend Kelly, definitely get on that. We still need to play Magic sometime. We're doing some tactical waiting here. It's not camping. It's tactical waiting. But we're probably going to move on from this spot in a second. Thank you. Mission success. Also, it only takes two light slugs to kill somebody? My goodness. I guess it was three, but it was just one in either leg. So they're both blacked out. Alright, I feel a little bit bad. But also, we really need these kills, so... No, I know, they are hollow points. They do a ton of damage. Yeah, so if you're just tuning in, my name is Deadpine. We're playing Hardcore Tarkov, which is self-imposed rules in Escape from Tarkov. That we delete our entire starting stash, including my pouch container. Nice. Which feels really good. Well, you know, it's you start naked. You start naked and afraid. Oh, they had a spear? Okay, well, we're ditching that. Just put that there. It's a new gun. That guy probably hates me. Yeah, this person definitely hates me. I'm so sorry. We are going to work on getting out here. Oh, wrong Vepr Hunter. Okay, don't care about that. But yeah, so, and then we can't do scav runs. We can't do buy from dealers. We can only barter with dealers. No insurance, no flea market. Turns Hardcore Tarkov, or at least we play it, turns it into a survival game. And less of a... go try to kill players. This is the new site, too. Not sure where that is. That might be, is that the new sound of the new gun? Might be. They had a bunch of markers as well. Jeez Louise. But Callie and crew, what were you guys up to today? What was everybody up to? Or, and if Callie had to go right away, all good. I understand. I know she plays a bit of a variety of games. It's always fun. Still ate Dead Man's food and drink. Well, he's not gonna eat it anymore. Level of 8. 32. The site is clean. Not sure. I'm gonna leave. We're done our shotgun tasks, and now we're on to just player kills on this map. Oh, I thought that rock formation was somebody crouched there. Oh, goodness. This was maybe this guy's friend. Oh, jeez. Walking backwards into rocks. right, GG. Got a plus one player kill for Punisher Part 4, and we got the last of our scavs. You'll have to see it. You'll love to see it. Nice. Got him in the right leg, my goodness. Nice. Oh, see the experience there, too. Nice. All right, GG. Look at that ammo type. 68 by 51, huh? Wild. Absolutely wild. This is probably who had all the grenades, because there was a ton of grenades going off there. My goodness. Oh, our stash is so ridiculously full. The nice thing is I could probably sell this. Because we are done with the shotgun tests there. I guess we need them on Shoreline now. So maybe we're not. It's FMJ, which I think is the second best. But it's also still really good. All right, I need to sell that. So we're also playing on it. For those who are just tuning in from the Cali raid, we are also playing on a standard account, which makes it even tougher. Because space becomes a real issue. Okay. How do I want to do this? I mean, I kind of want to keep doing this. You know? We need to get tremor headshot kills. We really need, the big gates right now is a drill. We need to find a drill and raid. We need to... We can start doing interchange stuff. We need to find a drill and raid, or whatever. We need to get a drill out of a raid. We need to... This is holding us back from a few things, I think. And then the tremor headshots, I think, are also holding us back from a few things, which we're halfway there on. Which is interesting. And we don't have any bolties to work on Tarkov Shooter Part 3. So I guess maybe we're going to interchange with this. It's a fine kit to go in with. We can just go in with this Sig Spear, I guess, and just sort of go from there. If we lose it, we lose it. Oh, well. It's not like a huge deal, you know. We got it for free, right? So let's just store all these away. I think the mechanism bag holds a heckin' lot more than it takes up, I think. 25 and it holds 32. Maybe it's not a heckin' lot more, but it does hold more than it takes up. And it can hold this, which is nice. So if you do that, put those away, put that away, put that there. I think I need to sell this and this. That's still taking up too much room there. Let's definitely sell those. Hit that with a repair. Oh, that is enough space. Hold on. That is enough space. I misjudged. And this can go here. And then, honestly, all the Yushunkas can go into here, because it's good at holding 2x2s. Which is nice. Yeah, good. Wear that. Or I kind of want a backpack I'm okay with ditching. So let's do this barter, which is a hard drive. Come on, servers. There you go. Okay. And then we do this. Put that back. Equip that. There you go. Yeah, I like that. This backpack, because if we need to ditch it to get two, like a drill or two out, done, right? Absolutely done. I think I'm going to use this in single fire, and I think I'm going to save this, and we're going to use, I don't know what we're going to use on there, some sort of red dot. Because I think that'll be best. That I guess I can't. Oh, with mechanic I can. take that. Okay, not going to wear those. Going to save that for our Balaclava Scav Vest kills, which we do need to get going. We'll put that away. Do we have keys? We don't really have keys for this map yet. We will. So my rule of the pouch containers is once I get a pouch container, I can put anything in, but I can't loot into it. But anything from the hideout can go into there. So I think we're going to do that. That, maybe. You know what I might do? I mean, it doesn't really matter if I save these FMJ rounds. Like, I haven't seen any of these loose. So, like, whatever. You know, I don't really care. It's fine. We're trying not to fight the world anyway. So what would I put into there? My injector case, maybe? Yeah. We just got to make sure we take out enough morphines for Peacekeeper later. And honestly, I'm going to take out one of those. And that should get us going. I can't loot into that, but, you know, this keeps us kind of going here. No worries. And, yeah, let's hop into our first, well, not our first interchange raid, but an interchange raid. And we're looking for drills is what we're looking for. Yeah. And we're looking to get stuff done, but I'm not really looking to get stuff done here, if that makes any sense. Like, I want one drill and I want to get out. That's really kind of where I want to be at. Yeah, because I'm trying to think what else is gating us here. It really is kind of like vitality and trying to get sniper rifles. So energy saving lamps would let us trade for sniper rifles. Beard oil, which spawns a lot of interchange, would let us get there. So that we'll keep an eye out for that stuff, and we'll see you in raid. All right, here we go. So this can full auto, but I don't... It's kind of like the MDR full auto, I think, where I just don't want to waste. I also only have 60, or like 61 rounds total, so... Feels a bit like a waste. Also, I didn't see any lag, so I guess Killa could be up. I have no idea how well this ammo does against Killa. If anything. So that shot was idea, I think. Two hand drills. I think the drills can spawn on those shelves, but I'm not 100%. I know fuel can. Maybe I'm thinking maybe I can get in and out of the food area quick. Oh, this new jumping, dude. I know I need to set it to a different key and I can make that jump fine. I just can't do that right now. Also, Tashunkas for our other task wouldn't be the worst either. The lighting is a lot better. I agree. No, downstairs is way clearer. Including upstairs as well, you know. But I don't. I tend to avoid upstairs if I can. We're good on the squash. It's the Tarkolas and the hot rods and the herring that we need. And the Tshunkas, I guess. Small Tshunkas. Oh, I didn't bring money for extract. He's trade for armor. It's bad armor, but it's armor nonetheless. Yeah, you know, could stop from shotgun pellets. This power station technically has drill spawns. Really wish I brought money for the extract. Snow. Moderate armor pen, high damage, okay. I know there's a lot of action and idea. So either the sound I heard was scavs spawning in? Or someone in idea. I know Wheelers and Chief were really obsessed with this gun when they first discovered it. It is their playstyle, you know. Looks like a scab there. Yes, PRS. Even better. So I don't know if it's just this map that the drills can spawn in these containers. Sometimes it feels like that. Car is here, so regret on not having money. fuck is that? Is that a vector? That sounds like a loud vector. Drink that. Snappy trigger. That's good. Zero recoil, but like that's kind of par for the course these days. How much do I need to make? 47.11. It's possible. Unlikely, but it's possible. Well, it's less possible when there's less jackets around. That for the barter. Put that key. I don't think it's a very important one. I guess it could be the Marin car key, but unlikely. I don't think these can spawn empty, so I guess whoever spawned here just looted these real quick then. Or maybe just that one. Hopefully this guy's got some money. Negative on the money. Literally holds one extra space, but you know what? That's fine. Even if we just sold that. Pretty happy about that. That was in this corner right here. All right, we're gonna run from that. No reason to be here. Could go in and check the spawns, but we're filled up enough where I like this was a food loot run, and that's okay. think interchange is, the power of interchange is making, if you're trying to loot interchange as a PMC, I think the power of it is making sure you play your spawn correctly. I wish there was a way you could, like, climb over these fence, this fence with the vaulting. That would be nice. We should be railway. We respawn right next to the Emmercom. Yeah. Could save that now, I guess. There's that vector again. Pretty sure that's what that is. Okay. That one's pretty nice for space. We'll just hit as many caches as we can on the way out here, because not only do we have room, but... Nice. Money's not, money's not the worst thing in the world to have right now. I really feel like I've seen drills... Where have I seen drills, chat? Where do you get your drills from? I know where they spawn in interchange, but I feel like I've seen a ton, and I was like, last wiper, like, we need to remember this spot for drills, and I can't not remember for the life of me where that was. Was it Lighthouse? Well, maybe New Shoreline has them now, yeah. But I'm talking about last wipe, I saw them. It might have been Lighthouse. Maybe the train area and Lighthouse had a few. I don't know. I guess Resort does have a few spawns for them, right? In all the locked rooms there. I guess the cool thing about Shoreline is most of my doubles, a lot of tool spawns in the streets. I see them though. Yeah, okay. It's a grizzly right there. Probably make room for that. All right. They're convenient, but they're not like necessary. Good morning, Magic. Mechanical Art Streets always seems to have them, but I know you don't like that map. Yeah, I don't love that map. But we could try. Duffel Toolbox on the streets have been good. Crane Area. Okay. Yeah, so maybe it's about time we head over to streets for that. I know streets is amazing for loot. It's a factor of also, can I get out with the loot as well? Person? God damn it, that was a person. God damn it. All right, well, we didn't lose anything too terribly bad. What a place to camp. I shouldn't have re-peeked when I said, is that a person? I should have peeked from a different angle to throw them off. That's how it goes. Hey, you know what? I did say, it was the thing I hate, honestly hate the most in this game, which is player scavs. Ruining my loot runs, man. I know, they're just after loot too. But nice shots, by the way, nice shots, player scav. That's nothing against you. That's as a whole. player scavs are doing what I'm doing most of the time, which is looting. I just want to loot in peace, you know, et cetera, et cetera. So not against a specific player scav. All right. Well, YouTube, that's going to do it for this episode. That's a bummer way to end. I was hoping to end with a nice little area there. And I shouldn't have re-peeked. I did see them, you know. It's not like they had, like, the world's best hiding spot. I saw them. I just re-peeked in the same spot like an idiot, you know. That's how it goes. But we had space to lose, so I'm not really worried about it. These HP rounds, though, that was kind of the highlight of this episode. I didn't realize you get, like, a two-shot on one leg. Now that there's less recoil, that's a lot easier to do. So I'm wondering if maybe we try that out on customs for our kills, you know? That might be a thing we do for the setup, you know? Try to think what we do next. Maybe we're hopping back on Shoreline. I do genuinely think Interchange right now is going to be my least favorite time. Because of all the player scavs, they come in waves and they just do not stop. Like, I wish you could know or guarantee that there would be only, and this is not, they can't do this because there's everybody wants to player scav and not actually play as a PMC, which is totally fine. That's great. You play how you want to play. But, like, there's more player scavs than there are PMCs, so they have to, like, kind of overload the servers with them. But it just feels like you just can't win. It's a never-ending army. So that means you have to get in and get out. And I hate looting that way. I hate playing that way. I want to loot the entire map and feel like I conquered it and cleared the area and then loot peace, you know? And not have this... Like clearing, then looting, then 100%ing everything is how I like to play games. And I get it. That's also not the thing that they're going for. So, but what are you going to do, right? What are you going to do? But yeah, we got a lot of stuff to work on here. It's nice to be a little bit further along in Punisher Part 4. Honestly, daytime with the Scavest Balaclava. We need to get snipers. Snipers with range. Get in there. Try to get some kills. I mean, we don't even need to do snipers on this, but it's just easier because they take up less room. We need to start looting Violent Caddis. Maybe we're going to streets for loot, you know? Maybe we're hopping into the streets, trying to get that drill out. And maybe streets was where I saw a bunch of drills, you know, in that one area. So, and people are going to be going into the new area a lot. So it's just a matter of avoiding the player scavs. Once again, same on that map. It's like a matter of avoiding the player scavs. At a certain point in the map, you know? But yeah, maybe we hop on there. You know, we have gear to lose. That's okay, you know? We can just take in this thing. We'll see when the time comes. The next episode we film is going to be during drops, and hopefully we'll be going for a very long time. Bummer about a couple of our deaths today during the course of the episodes, but what are you going to do, right? Not much to do about it. I think overall we came out pretty positive on the day. So, good stuff. YouTube, make sure you sub into the channel, and I'll catch you in the next episode.